James Rosenquist, Tom Otterness, Jackson Pollock, Thomas Hart Benton, Alexander Calder, Will Barnett, Georgia O'Keeffe, Robert Rauschenberg, Reginald Marsh, George Gross, Louise Nevelson, Lee Bontecue, Romare Bearden, Cy Twombly, Roy Lichtenstein, Audrey Flack, Louise Bourgeois, Mark Rothko, Al Hirschfeld, Norman Rockwell, Jules Pfeiffer, Hans Hoffman, George Bellows, Frederick Remington, Robert Henry, Everett Raymond Kinsler. These are just some of the names of America's greatest artists who have studied or taught at the Art Students League of New York.
I think it's fair to say that most artists who came into their own in the first half of the century went through the Art Students League. They taught, the school taught artists in the realist tradition, it taught artists who became the leaders of the abstract tradition in America, ran the full gamut of approaches and styles.
Founded in 1875, the League was created by artists as a supportive community for artists and their work, where art education is based on the European tradition of a professional artist teaching students the language of art in an atelier studio setting. While open to all who wish to attend, the League has always strived to help the most dedicated and talented students to succeed as professionals. Those students with the hopes and dreams of joining the illustrious list of the great artists of the future. The League is an open community of artists where studio classes taught by autonomous practicing artists enrich the lives of more than 3,000 students each year.
Our faculty are all professional artists, leaders in their field, representing a wide array of aesthetic philosophies and points of view. You decide, based on your own temperament, who is going to be best for you, based on the aesthetic you lean toward, and then you learn directly from that master.
Low monthly tuition, work-study programs, and merit scholarships for emerging artists help our community reflect the diversity that is New York. Weekly class concours exhibitions and receptions bring our students together to show, discuss, and celebrate their work.
The community, you know, it's such an interesting grouping of people. You learn from everybody. There's somebody here who's doing something similar to you, somebody who's struggling with the same problems as you. Without the League, I don't know what I would be doing. I'd probably be sitting around working some dead-end job, and it's opened my eyes to what I need to be doing.
Emmett Barak, a 21-year-old sculpture student on work study, recently became the youngest artist since Norman Rockwell to have his work purchased for the League's permanent collection.
I still wake up every day and I'm shocked. I can't believe it. Selling my piece was the biggest honor.
In addition to classes, the League offers extensive public arts programming at the League and throughout the city. New York has packed the League's Phyllis Harriman Mason Gallery for our free public lecture series, which offers fresh perspectives on topics from Rembrandt to painting on an iPad. The Seeds of the League program employs League artists to bring the joy and culture of visual arts to underserved kids and provides youth scholarships for League study.
I've gone into places where they really don't even know what oil paints are or anything like that, and you know, and just by leading by example, by showing them some of the work that I do and having them play around with some of these materials and all that other stuff, it's you should see it. It is like seeds because it just opens up, it blossoms them up, and they're so amazed at what they can do.
Clearly remains a very relevant art school today, and I one of the things about it that I think is the most valuable is it's a place where artists could go to learn the craft of making art.
Today, our commitment to training artists is being redoubled through a series of professional development initiatives. Exhibition outreach exhibits work of emerging League artists in public spaces 20 times a year. The Wittlichill Campus Artist in Residence Program has hosted more than 100 artists from 17 nations. Our latest professional development initiative, Model to Monument, Creating Art for Public Spaces, trains artists in the process of making public sculpture. M2M has installed 16 monumental works in partnership with the New York City Parks Department.
This is an amazing program because their work is being seen. It shows what they can do. It shows what the League is doing. And we're doing good works for the city. The artist's role now has a certain level of civic responsibility.
How is the League doing at training professional artists? Recently, several League alumni have had retrospective exhibitions at the Whitney Museum. All of America's major museum collections, including the Metropolitan and the Modern, have works by League instructors and living alumni, such as Nayland Blake, Carrie Moyer, and Deborah Koss. And how's this for success? In 2012, former League scholarship student and longtime League instructor Will Barnett was presented with a National Medal of Arts for his art and his teaching at the White House by President Obama. In any given month, League students and alumni are showing contemporary work in galleries throughout New York and in countless locations around the country. From the local press to the international media, League artists like 1980 student Ai Weiwei are being recognized for their contributions to art and society.
I spend more time here than with my family, than with my actual family. My family, this really is my, it's not even my second family, it is the family.
You know, this kind of story, I couldn't find anywhere in Japan. I think it's like some kind of New York magic or art student League magic, I don't know.
Who among the many emerging artists at the League today might join the pantheon of the world's great artists who have studied and taught at the League? The Art Students League of New York, where the echoes of history reverberate each day and inspire the artists of tomorrow.